You ready for ballet?
Yeah.
Busy bunny, let's get you changed for the next class. Let's get your tap shoes on. Oh, do you do tap first? Is it tap and then modern? We're just waiting for her tap and modern class to start. You're a busy bunny, aren't you? Yeah. And then I'll be able to properly start the vlog. This is funky. Feels like it's been ages since I last vlogged. It's only actually been a week. Not much has happened this week. Haven't got much to catch you guys up on. I mean, we are in another national lockdown, so there is that. It almost feels like the second half of the first lockdown, because there are still coffee shops open for takeaways. We can still go to the pub. So the only thing that we can't do is go and sit in a coffee shop, go to a restaurant and go visit friends and family. But apart from that, we have a bit more freedom compared to the first lockdown.
We thought you said we are going to the park.
Yeah,
and
go to the park.
Coffee shop.
Yeah. So mum and daddy thought we could walk into town and go get a coffee, baby Chino, and then go to the park. So yeah, we're thinking after lunch we'll nip out and have our daily outing, probably grab coffee from one of the local shops. Not a huge amount happening this weekend, but I thought it would be nice to vlog, because although it's been quite nice to have a bit of time off from constantly vlogging during Vlogtober, I've actually missed having a natter with you guys. Get your foot out of the way. Even though that sounds strange to say, because I'm just talking to a camera, I'm not actually talking to you guys in person. Get these feet away. Thought it'd be nice to film a little bit today, film a bit tomorrow, and then I can smush them together and make a bit of a weekend vlog. Do you mind? We've run out of bread, but I remembered we've got these wraps. So we're gonna have wraps for lunch. Delilah's asked for tuna, and I've got a fake chicken corn burger, which I'm going to chop up and put in my wrap with salad. What are you guys doing? Here's an avocado, darling.
Yeah.
Look at that for a good avocado.
Holly jolly Christmas.
I've given her a bit of avocado, cucumber and some fruit with her wrap. There you go. Lots and lots. Having a lunch in here, aren't we?
Hey.
You
thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Letter for daddy. It's just mummy's makeup remover. This. We'll open later when we get back, okay? I put my big coat on. I had to take it off and I put my jacket on. I looked on my weather app and it's about 16 outside. I'm going to pack a hat in case it happens to get chilly. Mask. And packing sunnies, because it's really sunny. It's been like it all week, which has been amazing after what felt like it had rained constantly throughout October. All week it's been really crisp and beautiful. My favourite kind of weather, where it's really chilly but sunny blue skies. Today, it's sunny blue skies, but it's actually fairly warm. Here's to hoping I don't have to take this jacket off. I've flung this jumper vest on over the top of my dungarees and it looks a little strange. You're gonna get a baby Chino?
Yeah.
Cool.
coffee.
Is that?
It's like a pumpkin.
Yeah.
Is that a flat white piece?
Thank you.
So this
actually
got
like
what I got.
And I just carry it for me.
Got myself a decaf cappuccino then in my bag somewhere hidden. It's cinnamon swirl, it looked too good.
Oh, so much
leaves. So many leaves. Crunch, 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 crunch.
Is that me?
Whee!
Tummy.
Making your tummy funny.
Yeah, funny.
Steps on the log.
Behind
us. Should we go investigate?
Yeah. My one is perfect. Temperature.
Cheers.
Cheers.
This is nice, isn't it? You gonna jump? Whoa.
You might do.
Wow!
Freaking egg collect.
Look at all those. You want me to hold them?
Yeah.
Okay. Were you taking them home?
Yeah.
Okie dokie. We're headed home now. It was nice to get out. I've not gotten out much this week. So it's been nice to leave the house. I think I've left the house one other time this week, apart from taking her to school. She just came, Mummy's vlogging again.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you like me vlogging, don't you?
Yeah,
exactly. She asks me if I'm vlogging sometimes. I'm like, oh no, not today. Anyway, heading home. This is one of my favourite parts of town. Love the houses down here. I mean, they cost a fortune. I don't think we'd ever be able to afford somewhere down here. But the houses are gorgeous.
Look, up there!
The Christmas decorations are up, aren't they? I ordered a few bits from one of my favourite independent shops. I first discovered them either on... I either discovered them on Instagram or Truva. There's one thing in here that I forgot I put in for Delilah and now she's seen it, but that's okay. First thing is this wrapping paper, because I thought a little someone might like this, because what sort of wrapping paper is it?
A nutcracker.
Nutcracker. And who loves a nutcracker?
Me.
You thought Delilah would like this for her Christmas present. And we have a couple of other boxes. I just love all the stuff that this shop sells. And oh, actually, the guys can't even see me there. Every year I tend to buy one or two more ornaments for the Christmas tree. Last year I bought a couple of these gorgeous moth ones. This was the shop that I bought them from. Do them again this year for anyone who wanted to buy them last year when you saw me, when you saw them in last year's Vlogmas. You got it. I did order another one because I don't think we have the pink one.
I want it in my bedroom.
You want it in your bedroom? That's for our Christmas tree. You want to show them up close?
Yeah.
So we have two of these for our tree already. And I thought I'd get this one because I loved these so much last year that I thought, oh, I wish we had Mommy, another please. One. Here we go, pop up.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, so we've got some more matches. Got some of these matches for the fireplace, mainly for the Christmas period because they're festive. Do you know what this is?
Mm-hmm.
This is a dish for candles. So a little candle dish. Hang on, I did order more wrapping paper from them. Oh, it says here, wrapping paper inside tube. Oh, it's inside here. That's clever. I just love the prints that they do.
I love it!
We've got snowflakes.
I love it.
Some of you may recognise this print from previous Christmases and Wrap With Me videos. So I've got another one of those. This gorgeous snowflake print. Couple of those. This print as well. I don't know how to describe it, but they just have this very kind of old style Christmas feel to them. And then this gorgeous red print as well, just like that up close. That's it, we've got a couple of those. And then candle wise they come in sets of six, and I went for the dusky pink color, the sage, what's this, olive green, and these are a slightly darker green. They are the moss green. And as I burn candles so much this time of year, especially when we have Christmas and we lay the table, we want to make it look all nice. These are the perfect size candles to have on the table. Are you decorating our drawers?
Yeah.
With stickers?
Yeah.
I love this colour, although I think this colour is a favourite because I may have gotten the last lot, or they said the stock was running low for these. Their name, Berry Loon, but I don't know if I'm saying that right. It's this shop here. I have purchased from them for a fair few years now. I love this so much. Oh, talking of Christmas tree decorations, I've actually got two other decorations that I bought new this year that I'll show you. I might as well, as I'm doing this. Yeah, I'll show you. I'll go get them. Saw these on Anthropology a month or so ago and they sold out. I left them in my basket too long and they sold out, and then recently they've gotten them in again, and this is part of a collaboration that they've done with a brand called Thirdly & Co. I think this one's my favorite, this starfish. How cute is that? I like that they're kind of quirky, but they also fit in with a lot of our Christmas decorations already, which are very kind of handmade, crafty style decorations. I'll link what I can out of all this stuff. Hello. I'd quite like a fire. Make it cozy. We've got nothing else to do with the rest of the day. Delilah's upstairs playing. She's in one of those really focused moods where she's in her own little world doing goodness knows what. I was really hoping my parcel from Oliver Bonus turned up, because I've ordered a couple bits from there. One of the items is a non-Christmassy puzzle, which I really wanted to do this evening because I've been going through a lot of puzzles and I don't want to go through all my Christmas puzzles before Christmas. Like when I ordered them at the start of the week, I thought, oh, I hope it comes when I'm vlogging. I really like showing you guys the new bits I get. It's like talking to a friend. Also gonna light this candle that you guys are sitting on. This is one of the candles I got as a Christmas gift last year. I don't know what the name was, but it was one of Diptyque's Christmas scents. Kind of smells like a Christmas tree. So I'm gonna light that. Smell the wood on the fire and the candle. Mustn't get too excited for Christmas just yet. We haven't got long. God, the lighting really is terrible in here. First week of November done. I feel like we can start to get excited for Christmas now. I'm thinking I'm gonna go upstairs and have a bath because there's not much else to do. Delilah's occupied doing her own thing. Can you keep an eye on her whilst I go upstairs? Thanks. I was gonna go for these bubbles, but then I remembered I had another bath bomb. I'm gonna go for this little guy. Ooh. Oh, that's like a dark blue, bluey purple. The book that I started reading this week is The Female Persuasion. I've never read anything from this author before. It's very different from anything that I've read, and I'm really enjoying it. I never normally read in the bath, but I'm gonna give it a go. Trying to find somewhere to put the camera.
It's weird as well, it's like separated.
Oh yeah, you guys see that? The bath bombs on the bottom.
I'm gonna put some nice music on, get this makeup off, put my hair up. It's the best feeling. It's gonna have some leftover curry for dinner tonight. Something easy but yummy. I really feel like I need my ends trimmed, just trimmed. I like the length, but I just need them neatened up a bit and thinned out. That's not going to happen anytime soon, is it? Oh dear, what's going on here? I'm going to catch up on last night's Gogglebox because I actually went to bed really early last night. Oh, that's not going to work, is it? I forgot how hard it was to put up long hair. I went to bed so early last night because I've been feeling really tired recently and didn't get the chance to watch Gogglebox, so I'm going to watch that.
So many of the neighbours are doing fireworks tonight. I only have myself to blame for this spot on my chin. I know better not to prod and poke at my skin, but what did I do? They'd finally all cleared up from all the ones that I had in October. Woo! They'd finally cleared up from all the ones that I had last month. But hopefully once this one settles down, all should be good. Anyway, I'm gonna enjoy my bath now and I'll see you guys in the morning.
So
many fireworks going on outside. This is not quite the relaxing bath I was hoping for.
Woken up to a very foggy morning.
Look at this little pickle. Morning. I was going to film the vlog this weekend on my other camera, my G7X, Canon G7X Mark III, which I've had for over a year now, and myself and many other YouTubers bought the camera at the time and didn't like it, and I'm pretty sure most of us are still using the Mark II. However, this one has started to click, not click, but you can hear the autofocus. You've always been able to hear it a little bit, but as the year's gone on, you can hear it more and more, and I'm really aware of it now when I'm editing and listening to the vlogs back. I think what I'm gonna have to do is sell these two cameras that I have, get some money for them, to then buy a new one of these. So yeah, if you've heard the clicking, I'm aware it's there. I know it's so annoying. I will get a new one soon, and hopefully the clicking won't be as loud. What do you want for breakfast? Cereal this morning because we're out of bread. Do you want your vitamins?
Yeah.
You're dancing. Oh yeah! Delilah's asked for strawberries on her cereal. This is just the Kellogg's Shapes cereal, I think it's called. It's actually really good. But I'm just gonna have it as well. It's definitely, it won't fill me up. This is why I never have cereal for breakfast, because cereal just doesn't fill me up. You can usually see rows of houses and the town and just over the whole of our town, and there's just nothing. It's so foggy. I love it. It's so feels so wintry. Spent most of our morning playing. We've played doctors, we've played with Delilah's mice, she's done a dinner party for the Disney princesses, she's laid out all the napkins on the dining room table. We've been running around playing all sorts this morning. I thought it was about time I got myself ready. Very likely gonna go for a walk. It's all we can do really. Get asked a lot about the mascara that I use. It's the Max Factor 2000 calorie mascara. It's the only one I've used for the last probably 10 plus years. It's a good mascara. I really like it, and I like mascaras with brushes, not plastic brushes. I like them to have actual brushes, if that makes sense, like bristle brushes. I've actually got some washing that I need to put away. Not just a basket of washing, but I've also got a pile of clothes behind that on the stool next to the chest of drawers that really need putting away. So I should probably put the washing away, and then we can decide what we're going to do for the day. Oh, and I had a text saying my Oliver Bonus parcel was going to be delivered today. So I can't wait to show you guys what I ordered. I feel a bit funny about doing hauls at the moment, because I worry that, because I'm not unaware that people are struggling, and I never want to come across as blasé about these things. Like, I'm really appreciative of the things I get, be it with my own money or sent from a company. I ordered the Oliver Bonus bits with my own money, but yeah, I never want to come across as ungrateful or blasé about being able to buy a few bits here and there. At the same time, I know lots of you like hauls. Anyway, I'm gonna find some clothes to get changed into, and then pop this washing away. Another day, another stripy t-shirt or jumper. I swear at least 80% of my wardrobe is striped. This is a People Tree jumper from 2-3 years ago. I got it in our old flats. It must be 3 years ago. Paired it with these jeans, which I've not worn in good month or so, only because I meant to be putting washing away and I'm getting distracted. But the bottoms have not worn very well. Hello, Pickle. Hi.
This is her card.
You've made a card for your friend?
Yeah.
Oh, lovely. This one had a letter through the door earlier, didn't you, from your friend?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure this is my fault, because I tumble dried them when I first got them, thinking I could shrink them because they were a bit too big on me. You definitely don't want to tumble dry jeans, especially ones with a raw hem, because this happens. They don't look the best. And annoyingly, they don't seem to have them in stock, or at least in stock in my size. Underneath this jumper, I just have a organic basics t-shirt. It's the softest thing. I haven't even got a bra on today because it's just so soft. It's a bit stretchy and it's just, it's so comfy. I'm actually going to put this washing away now. Are you putting my dressing gown on?
Yes.
So fluffy. Aww. Ordered these from a company called Sleepy Dough back in July time. I've mentioned them so much, so I'm sure you guys are sick of me talking about them. However, got those, and then I got myself a pair which you've seen me practically living in recently. Let me move you down here. And then lots of you must have gone over and shared the love, because out of nowhere I had a parcel through the door for Delilah, and they had sent her the version of mine but in the kids' size, and the kids come with the long bottoms. So not only was I not expecting anything through the post, but two pairs. And Delilah, actually, as much as Delilah loves these and she loves matching with me, you really like these ones, don't you, Bubba? They have these blue love hearts on, and she really loves these. I feel like this vlog's been very hauly, very show this and that, but I really just wanted to say a big thank you to these guys, because I know this was a thank you from them for giving them a shout out, but still I wasn't expecting anything from it. I think a lot of people think that vloggers mention stuff to get freebies. That's not what I'm about, especially with smaller brands. It's just what I do. I like showing stuff, and these certainly won't be the last ones that we get from them. I'm looking forward to their next collection launch, because I've come a bit obsessed with pyjamas. I don't really wear them in bed, but I like to wear them around the house in the mornings and the evenings. What should we get you dressed in today, Pop Pop? Easy peasy.
Yeah.
Okie dokie. Delilah has picked out some nice stretchy trousers. Oh, they're nice and warm on the inside, aren't they? And then what t-shirt would you like to wear with them? Wear that if you want. What's the saying about my stripy wardrobe? You need some pants. Do you want any help getting dressed, or can you do it?
I can do it.
Okie dokie. Should we have some lunch soon?
Yeah. These ones are the same. Is this the right one?
Yep. Gonna have some leftover butternut pasta for lunch, if I can get it open. I need two hands for this. Parcel has just arrived. I'm gonna have my lunch and then I'll show you what's inside. It's getting quite warm in this, so I've reluctantly had to put a bra on, because otherwise you guys would be getting an eyeful. Let me show you what I got. Free bar of lint. Here is the puzzle that I got myself. They have some really good puzzles and some really good games on there. I'm eyeing up a fair few games for Christmas. When my brain's feeling really busy and I can't concentrate, even with reading, I get distracted. I can only enjoy reading when I'm feeling quite calm, whereas doing puzzles, I find that really helps me to switch my brain off and to focus on one task. There's something that I find really cathartic about it. The only puzzles I have are Christmassy ones, and I've already finished the two 500 piece puzzles that I bought for Christmas time. So I got myself this donut one. They've also got a couple of they've got a cat one, which I'm pretty sure Doug's sister has. Delilah's been really enjoying helping me do puzzles, and genuinely she's been doing them with me. She helped me finish my other big puzzle. She's so cute. She'd get a piece in and go, yes, I got a piece. I'm really thinking about buying her some bigger puzzles for Christmas, because she's really good at them, and I think she'd actually be able to do I don't know what they go up in, maybe 100 piece puzzle quite well. Pick myself up one of these Rosie Toes instant pedicure feet things. Every now and again I like to give my feet a pamper, and it's cheaper than going to a spa and having them do essentially the stuff that you can do at home. Some of you may have noticed I'm partial to a doormat. So the one we have at the moment I got at the start of spring. Last year I'd gotten one from Oliver Bonus that had stars on. I said when we go into autumn winter again I would just put the other one back that we got from Oliver Bonus last year. How many times can I say Oliver Bonus? However, we've been using it in the kitchen and it's quite handy having it on the back door, so I used it as an excuse to get a new less summery one for the front door. It looks like this. I love it. It's got a very art deco feel to it. The last thing, haven't bought myself slippers for a few years now. I saw these and I thought they were so cute, but also I'd really like to have something next to the bed that I can just slip my feet into, because in our bathroom we have tiles and they are freezing in the morning. I can slip my feet into these now and my feet won't feel cold. I feel like I've got verbal diarrhea this weekend. I am just waffling on. So sorry guys. We're also going to be doing our wood floor in a couple of weeks in here. So excited. Lots of things happening around the house in the next month, so there's gonna be lots of new bits to show you housewise. I'm gonna see if these fit me. I got the, they don't have a size conversion online, but I got the medium large because I'm a size 6.5. Well, they only just about fit me. I don't really know how these would fit you if you had bigger than size 7 foot. They're so comfy. Our wood floor downstairs isn't actually that cold. The tiles in our bathroom are colder, and actually because we don't have proper tiles in the kitchen, it's lino, that also doesn't get too cold. So I don't think the wood floor in the bedroom is going to be particularly cold, because if anything it will be warmer because it's upstairs, it's not directly on the ground, whereas downstairs underneath the wood floor is just ground. So I'm not thinking the bedroom's going to feel particularly cold because of it, but I also thought now I've got slippers I can have them next to the bed, slide my feet in them in the morning, keep them nice and warm. That really is it for all the new bits to show you in this vlog. I should be able to link everything like I always say. Let's go change this over. These slippers are so squishy. Do you like my new slippers?
Yeah, I like bunny slippers.
Just fluffy slippers. Boop, boop. No, they're mine.
Is that a new one? Is that a new one?
It is, yeah.
For here?
Yeah. Can I have my slippers back?
No.
Mummy, you're squishy.
Daddy didn't want a cuddle from Mummy. I can't see. We are going to the park.
Off we go. Skate, skate. Can you do the letters?
Mm.
Good job. That one? Oh. Oh, oh. What's that one?
Yeah.
Yeah, good job, darling. What's that?
Yeah.
You can have a turn now.
Mummy's go.
Hold it.
Woo! Oh! That make your tummy?
It did make my tummy funny. Oh, help me! Help! Don't pull my head. Mummy's legs are a bit long for that one. Daddy's go. Should we get home and have some hot chocolate?
Yep, and a feel.
Woohoo! It's dirty bum.
What cup would you like, huh? Your normal cup? I'll probably just have a little bit.
I want a lot, Daddy. What can I do?
After last night's bath bomb, the bath needs a good scrub. It's left it looking like this. Can you see that? It's all black. I'm gonna get this cleaned, and I might as well clean the rest of the bathroom and the loo whilst I'm at it. Thank you. butter.
Fireworks!
Been loads of fireworks recently, haven't there?
This is the best day ever.
It's in my new puzzle. I'm gonna start this tonight and then you can help me do some tomorrow if you want.
Easy, they're not easy bits.
May do the tricky bits?
Yeah.
Looking forward to school tomorrow?
Yeah.
So on Tuesday you've got your school photos. Give the photographer a big cheesy smile. Just like that, lovely.
They will think I'm so beautiful in the morning.
You are so beautiful.
And help me open this and then I need to put you to bed. Like, this is what it's meant to look like.
12 and 30 and 20.
She really wanted to open this puzzle with me before she went to bed. Doug's just gone off to work. He's been on nights the latter half of this week.
How many?
What's your favourite one?
All of those.
All of them. Oh yeah, I get so many questions asking what Doug's job is. It's a bit of a Chandler Bing job. You say what he does and people look at you confused. He's a rope access technician. Don't know how to explain it. I'm sure if you googled it, there'd be a much better explanation with what he does. The jobs vary time to time. You're a soldier, hello.
I'm a soldier.
Sometimes they need them to work nights for reasons like closing bridges. He's been doing a lot of bridge work recently in London. And when he's not hanging off bridges, he's usually hanging off the side of a building. Tomorrow he'll be off and then he'll be back today's as of Tuesday. So it's just been me and this tinker for the last few evenings.
Do you mean tinker?
No, I mean tinker, because you're a little tinker. This fire is not doing too well, is it?
No.
Because the logs and kindling are a bit damp. Spoken to a couple of carpenters regarding doing the doors underneath the stairs. On the smallest part of the stairs, we'd like to have a log store. We won't be able to fit loads. Pop, do you want to help me? There we go, it's picking up a bit now. Mm-hmm. We won't be able to fit loads of logs in there, but it will just mean that we've got one log in the house to access, so we're not having to go out every time we have a fire. It will also mean we won't have to have this basket here, because I don't really like having that basket there. But it will also mean that hopefully the logs won't get so damp, so we'll have some logs inside that will be less damp and have more chance to dry out, because these are straight from the outhouse and it's a little bit damp. Should we put you to bed? Should we go find a story? Yeah, come on then. There once was a velveteen rabbit, and in the beginning he was really splendid. He was fat and bunchy, as a rabbit should be. Dinner tonight is a very quick and easy cheese roast dinner, mainly courtesy of Aunt Bessie, and some corn sausages. Also got some Aunt Bessie Yorkshires. And then I'll fling on some veg, make some gravy. I think I might just pop on Graham Norton or Jonathan Ross, something like that. I'm still holding off to watch the new season of This Is Us.
Whoa.
It's a lot of pieces. Definitely not gonna be able to fit this all on the table, but I'll start it here and then I'll have to move it onto the mat. There are loads of pieces that are already together. I mean, it makes sense I just keep them like that. I don't know, I feel like I'm cheating. Look, it's more. Let's see if I have a Jonathan Ross to watch. I usually prefer Graham Norton over Jonathan Ross, but at the moment, the way it's been shot, I'm preferring Jonathan Ross just because it feels a bit cozier with the way it's been laid out with social distancing. Honestly, it's so crazy to look back on this time last year to think that we had no idea what was ahead of us this year and how different life is. It feels so normal now, walking around with a mask on, social distancing. It's going to feel so strange when things do eventually, at some point, it will happen. Who knows when, but at some point, things will go back to how they used to be and it will feel so strange. I don't know about you guys, but I find myself watching stuff on
Why
telly.
Why is it important?
Oh, shh, loud. I find myself watching things on TV where people are close to each other. And my brain thinks, no, no, that's wrong. Shouldn't be doing that. It's odd, isn't it? Who knew anyway? Oh, oh. What? I'm a celebrity. Oh, Jungle Story. I'm a celebrity. Get Me Out of Here starts next week. I've not watched it for years. I loved it as a kid and a teenager, but I kind of went off of it. But I'm tempted to watch it this year because it's actually, it's not in Australia this year. Have we got a Jonathan Ross? Yes, we do. I'll just pop that on.
And as we're back in lockdown. Who could have possibly predicted that? Well,
I was about to tuck into my dinner, which is so beige, it looks so stodgy, but I can't wait to tuck in. I'm really hungry. I realised that I didn't have any, had some snacks this morning, but I didn't have any snacks between lunch and, oh no, I did have a little bit of cake. Okay, I've not eaten as much as I usually do, and I'm really hungry now. Yeah, I was about to tuck into this. I thought I should probably say goodbye now before I forget. I always feel like I need a reason to vlog when I'm not doing the Vlogtopers and the Vlooms and Vlogmases. So this weekend I just thought, no, I want to get a vlog up next week. Like, I'm just going to film like I would do if it was Vlogtober. It'd be nice to check back in with you guys. And I can hear the camera now clicking. So I need to get a new camera sorted out. So yeah, I do feel like November's going really quickly, and before we know it, it's going to be Vlogmas. Honestly, every time I go to say goodbye, I think I'm just going to do a really quick goodbye, and then I end up talking for ages. It's like when you say, oh, I should probably go now, when you're on the phone to someone, and then you end up talking about something else. Or Tuck always laughs at my mum and I, because we'll be on the phone, and we're going, oh yes, yes, okay, yeah, I'm gonna go now. Okay, yeah, bye. Oh yes, yep, 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 bye. Okay, love you, yeah, bye, 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 bye. Tell me I'm not the only one that does that. I'm sending all my love, and I hope you guys are all good. You know, if you're struggling at the moment with everything that's been going on, feel free to vent in the comments. I generally have, apart from the odd few, I genuinely have a really nice community on here, I feel, and it's always so nice whenever I've started a discussion on something to read your comments, and then to read other people's comments replying to those comments and seeing the discussion that's happening. And it's really polite and respectful, and it's just really lovely to see this kind of little community on the corner of the internet that I have. Yeah, if you're struggling and you just want somewhere to vent, feel free to do it in the comments. Even if I don't reply, I'm sure that someone else will reply. I want to be helpful and show my support, and I know these vlogs can give a little bit of comfort, which is nice, but I always feel like I want to be able to do more. Oh my goodness, I really am gonna go now. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next vlog. Bye.
Goodbye.